Hi everybody, this is Sean Overton with OneStepRemove.com. In this video we're going to talk about the MetaTrader Optimizer, and I'm going to go through some of the basic settings here. For the purpose of this video, I'm talking about this button right here, which will change MetaTrader from running a simple backtest into running a bunch of backtests. So what that really means is that you're going to try to test 20, 50, or even several hundred different combinations to see which one turns out the most profit. The idea is that all of your variables will change, and by changing them you can adjust the total return, or you can minimize the drawdown, you can optimize the performance for some feature that you're looking for. Overwhelmingly, with the traders I work with, they want to optimize the profit. So in order to do that, what you do is you click this optimization button and then you'll click on the expert properties. If you select an EA that is a little more common, so let me select something that everybody has, the MACD sample. This comes default with MetaTrader. The testing tab is exactly what you'll see whenever you're running a test. You can select the deposit and then whether you want to trade long only or short only. And then here you can optimize for what you intend to optimize for. In this case, and like everybody, you'll probably optimize for the balance, but you also have a couple of options to select from. The genetic algorithm will potentially, well, it will speed up your backtest and the optimization process. The advantage to this is that whenever MetaTrader detects that another combination that you're about to try will almost certainly fail, it just tosses it. But if you are trying to test something and it tosses it, you risk the possibility of throwing out a potentially good result. It really depends on how good the genetic algorithm that they're using is, and I'm not a huge fan of the capabilities of the MetaTrader backtester, so I would be leery of using this unless I was just trying to get a quick idea of where I might find hotspots in the different settings. The inputs is really what you need to focus on for the optimization process. For a regular backtest, this value column is all that's used. If you're running an optimization, it's these three columns that are used. So you'll use the start, the step, and the stop columns. With the take profit, let's assume that I just wanted to optimize for a take profit and I wanted to check every value between 5 and 300. I could type in 5 for the start and I would stop at 300. Now, this is an important consideration. You want to consider the interval between each step. So if I set the step at, say, 15, then I would start at 5, then the next step would be 20, then the next step would be 15 more at 30, and so on until I got to 300. Now, the finer you make this step, the more results that you'll get, but that also means you're running several hundred back tests. In this case, you'd be running 295 individual back tests, just optimizing for one variable. So you got to be careful with that, because it's a real pain to stop the back test once you get it going. The last tab is the optimization tab, and you probably will never visit this, but on the off chance that you do, you can throw out results based on what you consider unacceptable. I don't even know why they have consecutive wins. That's a nice problem to have, in my opinion, but if you have, say, 10 consecutive losses and you just can't stomach that for some reason, then you can throw it out. Or you can say consecutive losses in dollar amounts, and all of these options you see here. So there's really a lot to choose from. You push OK, and then from there on, it's just like running any other back test. You just push the start button. The last issue I wanted to address is curve fitting, because this will make you very susceptible to curve fitting your results. And what that means is that you picked the optimal outcome for some period, and in this case, it's a 3-day window between August 5th and August 8th of last year. Now, that's fine and it seems like a good idea, but what we find in practice with system development is that optimizing for one set of data tends to lead to weak performance on a new set of data. So you might pick the optimal result for historical data, but because everybody knows what the optimal result was, they tend to change their behavior, and what that results in is a feedback loop where what used to work doesn't work. Optimization to this degree, where you only pick the perfect variable, is curve fitting, and that comes with its own host of problems. So I'd just caution you to be careful of the risks of curve fitting when you are running a backtest and an optimization. That concludes the video. If you have any questions about optimizing or using the MetaTrader platform, please contact me. My name is Sean Overton, and I'm with OneStepRemove.com. Thank you for listening.